Welcome back, Star Wars fans, to episode 168 of Reynolds Reviews. And on today's episode, we've got a random eBay pickup, a great deal from VTR Dave, and some items all the way from the US. Cue the match. Welcome back, everyone. Now, like I said in the intro, today we're going to take a look at a random eBay pickup, a great deal from our VTR Dave, but also some items that arrived recently all the way from the USA. Now, I'm very, very lucky to be supported by some amazing people, and VTR Dave is one of those guys that not only gives me fantastic deals on things that I might want, but he also allows me to jump on his USA parcels. Now, Dave often buys from the US, and he's very, very gracious and very kind to allow me to add some things to those parcels here and there. I often find good deals in America, and he's very nice to allow me to do that. So I've done that recently, and a few weeks ago, the package arrived, and it contains some very nice vintage goodness. Let's go take a look. Okay, so we're going to start with my random eBay pickup. Now, this was an impulse buy. I just so happened to spot it with about 2 or 3 minutes to go, no bids. It was on $3.99. I just thought, you know what, if I can pick it up for one bid, I'll do that. Now, this is a line that some of you may be familiar with, some of you may not. This is a line called Sectors, Warriors of Symbian. And this is a line that I've kind of had my eye on and been tempted by for quite a while now. It is a line that I sort of had a handful as a kid. I say a handful, I think I only remember two figures. This was one of them. Now, this is a figure called Prince Dargon. And I remember having this one, and I had another Prince Dargon, but in silver. And I believe that was Prince Dargon Night Fighting. And he had a huge all in silver. He looked really, really cool. I remember thinking that as a kid. He just looked so cool in that outfit. But like I say, because I had a handful as a kid, I've always kind of been drawn to this line. Now, this guy, like I say, I picked him up for one bid. It stands me about £6, including postage. So I thought it was worth picking up for that price. And I just think they're such a cool looking figure and quite unique, you know, nothing really like this. Back then, so I thought it was really cool. Now, like I say, for the price I paid, obviously he's not complete, but he does have his rifle, as you can see. He also has his gun belt. He should have two pistols, a sword, and a shield. So he's far from complete, but at $3.99 opening bid, I felt this guy was worth picking up. And the beauty of this line is they're very, very affordable. Very affordable, even when you get them complete. As long as you're getting them loose, they are really affordable. Carded, obviously, they start becoming pricey, but other than that, they're a really, really good line to buy, and they're not going to hurt your wallet, which is great. But I love this guy, love how he looks, and often the antennas are snapped off on their head, but these are both intact, so I thought it was worth picking up. Now, I'm not going to spend too much time on this guy, because once I've picked up a few more, I will start picking up some more of these now, another new line to the base. Once I've picked up a few more, I will do a video dedicated to the Sectors, but I just love them. They're not a huge line, I don't recall them being too many, so I will start to pick up a few more, but hopefully I can get a good collection and then do a video. But back in the 80s, they had their own comic as well, so they must have been a fairly successful line because they had their own comic. They did have quite a few figures, and like they sort of had animals like insects, obviously, that they used to ride on and things like that. And I just thought, you know what, this is a really cool line and I think it's worth picking up. So because it's so affordable now, like I said, it's not a line I planned on buying, but because I picked this one up on impulse at a very cheap price, I will start picking a few up now. But like I've said in previous videos, I'm enjoying big figures at the moment, sort of 6 and 7 inch figures. And yeah, absolutely love this guy. So keep an eye on the channel. I will be picking up some more Sectors now. I think this is a really good starting point, but I'm going to pick up Prince Dargon Night Fighting as well, because like I said, I had him as a kid. So I'm going to start with these two and see where we go. But keep an eye on the channel. There will be some more Sectors coming. Okay, so let's move on to the bargain I got from VTR Dave.
Troutman, this is the end.
Okay, so now we're moving on to the awesome deal I got off VTR Dave recently. Now, this arrived about a week or two ago, and Dave was having a little bit of a clear out, I think, and he got in touch with me and said, are you interested in any more Rambo figures, Luke? I said, absolutely, of course I am. It depends who it is, obviously, because I've got a few. He asked me if I've got Sergeant Havoc, and I said, absolutely not. No, I would love a Havoc in my collection. Well, Like Dave, he gave me a great deal because this guy is complete. I mean, Dave never really moves anything on that's not complete. I think it's a little bit of a personal thing for him, but I mean, look at this guy. Even Dave's spares are like mint condition. I mean, his tattoo is there. That's often rubbed off. But as you can see, this guy is complete. He's got his belt, he's got his pistol in his gun holder there. We've got this huge machete in his belt as well. He's got the rifle, he's got his binoculars, which are often missing. And of course, we've got the signature rocket launcher. And this guy is absolutely awesome. Now, there was a bit of controversy. I'm probably not telling you anything you don't already know, but a bit of controversy over the Rambo figures back in the 80s, because obviously Rambo as a movie was an R-rated movie, an 18 movie, so there's a little bit of controversy. But in the end, Coleco got around it by basing these on the Rambo Force of Freedom cartoon, which I loved watching as a kid.
We've lost the Destroyer, Havoc. What's going on out there?
It's Rambo, sir. He's
Rambo. You ought to be able to take care of him with all this.
Yes, sir.
But this guy is wicked. He's going to go beautifully into my collection. Now, I'm not going to tell you what Dave charged me for this, but what I will say is, considering he is complete, I got this for an absolute steal. He offered me a great deal and I just couldn't refuse it. So Rambo, obviously, is a line. There was not many figures. There were some figures planned to be released after the first wave. I believe Dave will be able to tell me if I'm wrong. That never actually hit the shelves. Most of the figures are still reasonably priced, but they come with tons of accessories. I'm absolutely dreading picking up Gripper. He comes with like a million Uzis, and you just know you're not going to be able to get one complete. But one figure I would love to get from the Rambo line, which I believe Dave has got, which I just don't believe I'll ever own, is a fully functional Dr. Hyde. I just think what an amazing figure that is. But to get one is so expensive, and they're often without their battery covers and all incomplete and look all a bit battered and bruised. But yeah, I absolutely love this guy. So that's another figure down. You know what, I've probably got enough now to do a video on Rambo Force of Freedom, so let me know in the comments if you'd like to see that. I've got around six or seven figures now, so I've probably got enough to do a video. But yeah, this guy is super cool. So if you unravel the string at the back as well, pull this back, this is spring loading, it does fire out the rocket. But man, and look at that savage emblem on his stomach. I just think these are so cool. And again, had a handful as a kid, didn't have many, but I remember watching the cartoon, and it's an awesome line. So I'm going to pick more up of these as well. And as I've said in previous videos, I'm loving diversifying the collection at the moment in the room. I walk in now and see so many different toy lines. I'm really enjoying it. So thank you again, Dave, for giving me such a good deal. I love this guy, and obviously he will be treasured in my collection now. That is one more figure down. Plenty to go, but I'll keep plucking away at them. Okay, so let's go see what I got from the US. Okay, here we go, everyone. So this is the parcel all the way from the US, but obviously via VTR Dave as well, because like I said in the intro, he does allow me to jump on his US parcel. So this has come from the US to Dave, to me. So let's see what we've got. So we've got a little post-it there, look. Hey, Luke. Your goodies from the US. Enjoy, VTR Dave. Thank you, Dave. And now, I'm going to open this one first. So this one is just a tiny accessory that I need. You may well recognise this. I'm not going to show this in any more detail, but that is the rocket for my Doctera from the Centurion. So I just need one more little piece for Doctera now for him to be complete. I just need one more claw, but that is the missile. So thank you, Dave. But the real gems are still to come. Here we go. So I'm going to quickly get them out and then we'll have a proper look at them. So as you can see, we have got some carded Supernaturals. So let's get them on the table and take a closer look. Here we go. So as you can see, I picked up three carded Supernaturals Ghostlings. Now, like I said earlier in the video, I'm really enjoying the 80s lines up with the larger figures. So like I said, things like Supernaturals, Centurions, Thundercats, Bravestar, all the figures that sort of fall in that category. And the Ghostlings are like smaller figures that you used to get to accompany the larger Supernatural figures. But I think these are awesome. And back in the day when hologramic figures were sort of becoming all the rage, but these were awesome. I can't remember offhand how many there were. I think there were around half a dozen Ghostlings, but the outer shell, the outer cloak used to come off and then you were left with a hologram. But these are so cool. And if you get the light to hit them right, obviously you can see the hologram change inside, and I just loved Supernaturals. And if you remember the story, I used to get these from a shop called Nixie Plonks in our local town, and they come with a sword at the bottom there. Now, all the weapons were glow in the dark, and you even got a little comic at the back of them as well, man. But I absolutely love these. So this one is called See Through, and I think the cards are awesome. Now, the cards are all the same. We don't get like images like we do on other toy lines, but I just think they're awesome. And then on the back, so we used to be able to get 8 Ghostlings. So they're all on the back there. So as you can see, and again, the back of the cards, awesome. They're huge cards, and we got all the figures look to show us instead of just a ton of legal jargon back when we used to get images on the backs of the cards. And then we've got the proof of purchase in the bottom corner there as well. But man, I loved these. And surprisingly, these were actually released by Tonka. Now, back in the 80s, in my head, I always remember thinking Tonka were like the sort of dump trucks and all the sort of construction toys that they used to claim you couldn't break. When I think of Tonka toys, that's what I think of. I certainly don't think of action figures like this, but yeah, these were released by Tonka. But I love these. Absolutely love them. These are going to stay on the cards, though. Okay, so that's See-Through. Let's move on to Vampa. Okay, and there is Vampa, or Vampire. I'm not sure how you would... how you pronounce it, really. But yeah, again, very much the same. Obviously, we've got a different hologram inside, different coloured cloak, but again, they come with a sword. Now, the swords are always slightly different in detail, but they all glow in the dark. They all came with a comic at the back. But again, I just love these guys and just accompany the other figures really, really well. The cards, like I said, are all the same. I'm not going to look at the back of this card, but because again, they're all the same, but just super cool. So yeah, really appreciate you letting me jump on US parcel and picking these up, Dave. Now we're going to look at Spooks, and then I'll tell you what I picked these up for. And there we go, and there is Spooks. And I just think they look cool. I mean, that vibrant green, I think that really stands out. The others are quite dark colours, but you can get brighter colours. I think you can get like oranges as well, but I love this one. And again, it comes with a sword, slightly different in detail. We've got the comic at the back, but man, these are so cool. Now, like I said, you know, these are original carded. The cards are in great condition as well. There's a little bit of curling here and there, but certainly nothing that would concern me. I am going to pick up some acrylic cases to put these in. I'm not entirely sure where I would get them from, actually, because these are really large. I don't know if GW acrylic do them. They look maybe Thundercat size. I wonder if they'd work. But the reason why I picked these up was because, again, I love Supernaturals. I'm always on the lookout. But the cheapest carded Ghostling I could find in the UK at the time that I was looking on eBay was £80, and that was for one. I couldn't find them any cheaper. In fact, I struggled to find them carded at all, never mind at a decent price. And then I managed to find a seller in America that was selling these for what was the equivalent of £25 each, and that is including postage. So I actually picked up all three of these for the equivalent of £75 posted. I got in touch with Dave, he picked them up for me. But to say that I got all three for cheaper than I was finding one in the UK, this is why I appreciate so much what Dave does for me. He allows me to do this. And considering I'm on a really tight budget, having that option is amazing. So I got all three of these original carded for less than what I could find one in the UK. So £75 delivered. And I think that is a steal. So thank you once again, Dave, for letting me do that. These are going to look amazing in my collection. They will display nicely with the Tomb of Doom and with my carded Lionheart, very kindly sent to me for Christmas by our Ron. So yeah, very, very pleased to get these into my collection. Okay, let's get everything back on the table and we'll wrap up. And there we go, everyone. So not a bad week once again. Keep an eye on the channel. We've got Prince Dag on there from the Sectors. We will be getting more Sectors on the channel soon. Once I pick up a few more, I will do a video dedicated to Sectors. I will also do a video to Rambo now. Now I've got several figures in my collection. I think that will make a good video, so look out for that as well. But I just want to say again, a huge, huge thank you to our VTR Dave, not for just giving me an amazing deal on Sergeant Havoc, but also once again letting me piggyback on his US deals and letting me get all these Ghostlings. £75 for all three. I could not resist it. So again, keep an eye on the channel. There'll be more Supernaturals to come as well. But yeah, I'm loving diversifying the collection at the moment, and that will continue. So yeah, there we go, everyone. Hope you enjoyed that. If you're new to the channel, thanks for stopping by and giving me a shot. I hope you'll consider leaving a like and subscribing. And if you're one of my existing viewers and existing subscribers, thanks for sticking with me, everyone. I really do appreciate it. Leave any comments or questions in the comment section below. I always try to read everyone's comments and get back to everybody. And as always, keep collecting. I'll see you next time.